Muslim. What is the Wahhabi sect in Al-Madinatul Munawwara and Makkah Al-Mukarramah doing with all the historical sites and any relics of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, destroying them? Even though the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا تَهْدِمُ آطَامَ الْمَدِينَةِ فَإِنَّهَا زِينَةٌ لَهَا. Do not destroy the vestiges of Al-Madinatul Munawwara. They are the beauty of the city, mentioned by Al-Imam Abu Ja'far al-Tahawi in Sharh Ma'ani al-Athar. So this daughter of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anh had the garment of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which she kept and preserved. But not only kept and preserved, she would wash the garment and seek blessings with it and give the water to the people to give them a cure. We know that Al-Imam Ahmad, when Al-Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala dispatched someone to inform Al-Imam Ahmad that he shall undergo a trial and he should have patience, and he requested the shirt of Al-Imam Ahmad. Al-Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal removed his shirt and gave it. Al-Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala would utilize that shirt for barakah, for blessings. Today, people would term that as being shirk and bid'ah. Or for instance, Al-Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal would touch the mimbar, the pulpit of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and seek blessings. How? By touching and doing dua to Allah. If a piece of wood, like the mimbar, can have barakah, then imagine the status of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Likewise, similarly, from the various companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we know that they took the hairs, sha'arat, of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that it states in Bukhari and Muslim, in both Bukhari and Muslim, during the Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, so during the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, the companion radiallahu ta'ala anhu states, Wallahi, ma tankhimu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam nukhamatan illa waqa'at fi kafi rajulin minhum. That if the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spat, it would land in the palm of a person. فَدَّلَكَ بِهِ بِهَا وَجْهَهُ وَجِلْدَهُ. He would wipe his skin, a face and skin with this. Today, there are people who are associated with the Wahhabi sect would not have this belief. But this is the belief of the companions, Ali Muridwan, the belief of the Sahaba, that from the spittle of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they would wipe it on their face and on their skin. وَإِذَا أَمَرَهُمْ إِبْتَدَرُوا أَمْرَهُ. When he would command them to